Number one, rescission of the contract between Forsyth County and Advanced Ambulance Service. Ken?
Something I'd like to read if I may.
Well, it's the county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, that is what, it's just a rescission on the agenda, which means the simple majority can be taken to rescind something for which there's been prior notice. This would retain to the agreement for ambulance services that was approved on December 6th, but of which you don't have a written agreement yet. And so, Commissioner Levent, I believe it's the floor is yours.
Because of the discussion we've had in the past, I'm gonna make the motion with the intent that I believe we're gonna re-accept a different agreement. On December 6th, 2012, the Board of Commissioners authorized an amendment of an agreement between Forsyth County Advanced Ambulance that included, among other things, a 10% rate increase for 2013. That would then be followed by a 3% rate increase for the duration of the agreement. However, based upon subsequent discussions with Advanced Ambulance, it has been learned that Advanced Ambulance is prepared to accept less than a 10% increase for 2013. Those new terms will be discussed in the next agenda item, consequently, because no written agreement has been signed affecting that 10% amendment, it is appropriate to rescind it. Therefore, I move that the board rescind the December 6th, 2012 vote approving the contract amendment between Forsyth County and Advanced Ambulance.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion?
Just real quick, was that meant to be time sensitive, given that we're about to consider another?
Absolutely. I'm sorry. My motion is.
And ask the maker of the second if they're.
Second.
Okay. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries 5-0 to rescind the contract. Approval. Item two, consideration of amendment to the ambulance contract between Forsyth County and Advanced Ambulance. County attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this is sort of the other shoe to drop with respect to the first agenda item. We had been working on memorializing what the board had agreed to in December and didn't have that done yet. And in light of the additional negotiations, it made no sense to bring you an agreement that would eventually or immediately be amended. So this all makes sense from a timing standpoint. What I have in front of me and what you have not had the benefit of yet, and I'll explain why, is an amendment that would take the place of what Commissioner Levent just rescinded, what the board just rescinded. The amendment would, for all practical purposes, be the same deal, except for two critical issues, and I want to roll through them very quickly with you. Number one pertains to what was mentioned in Commissioner Levent's motion for rescission, which is the amount of the enhanced fee for 2013. I believe that in the amendment that was done in December, it was 3% plus 7% in 2013 for a total of 10%. And then, of course, every year thereafter, it would be 3%, but it would already be on top of the 10%. Everybody understands? So it would almost have a little bit of a compounding effect, and I think that was causing some folks some heartburn. What this new amendment would do would change the 2013 increase to 8%, which would be 3% plus 5% for 1 year. Then at the end of 2013, rather than have the next year's 3% go on top of that 8%, it would in fact only be 3% over a 2013 figure as if it had been 3%. Everybody following me? So in other words, the 5% increase only has a 1 year lifespan and then is gone. So we have modified the agreement to include that. I believe the representatives of Advanced are comfortable with that. But I do want to bring you to an issue that I'm still grappling with, which is why I don't have something literally that you could sign today, and I want y'all to hear this as well. I don't think it'll be anything too terribly difficult to understand or news to anybody, but here's what I'm dealing with. One of the issues that we agreed to in December was a buyback, meaning that during the course of the agreement, if at any time the county went with our own ambulance fleet or decided to part ways with Advanced, we would agree to buy back that equipment that was dedicated to handling the county's ambulance service from Advanced. Okay, that's fairly clear, and I think I understand that. So Advanced, in good faith, has provided us a list of the equipment for which we would be required to buy back. That's easy. The problem is that for a multi-year agreement, I have to be able to tell you for each year of its renewal what your financial obligation would be for that year. Which means that in year three, if we decide to terminate and go our own way with an ambulance contract or perform our own ambulance services in-house, the law says you need to know the exact amount of your obligation financially, which would include that buyback, right? So I have to therefore be able to do, one, an assessment of the value of all that equipment that's dedicated to our ambulance service, right? And then I have to depreciate it over the life of this contract so that literally with the turn of the page, you could look and say, okay, in year three, if we decide to terminate, we have to pay this much in fees and buy back this exact amount. Everybody with me? All right. I have numbers, but I've been speaking with David and Gruen from finance. Our concern is we don't have, and please don't take this the wrong way, but we don't have a way of confirming the present value of the equipment right now without someone being able to go out there and provide us a third-party figure on what that equipment is worth. Everybody with me? That's the only concern I'm having. I just want to make sure our baseline is accurate. These gentlemen have been good enough to provide us the list of equipment and their estimates, but I think in all candor, we probably ought to make sure that their estimates and maybe a third-party estimate are the same.
Is that necessary absolutely now, or if that comes to fruition?
It needs to be now, because I've got to have something in writing that you can know now that if you terminate in year three, here's exactly what we have to pay these gentlemen.
So you're looking for a number today with a fair depreciation amount each year percentage?
Correct. And the only issue I have, Mr. Gruen has run all the numbers, it's just making sure I have that figure today is accurate.
Startup number.
So all I would ask of you then, I'm happy with this agreement. I think, you know, let's go forward. But please allow me to have somebody come in and run these numbers and make sure those numbers square.
I think Mr. Rutledge wanted to say something
about it. It's going to change because we're remounting and bringing new trucks. So each year you're going to have a newer truck on board. So I don't know how you want to work that.
Well, see, we talked. That's going to be challenging because to the extent the fleet keeps changing in and out and new equipment, I don't know that I can't capture that unless we open it up and have a new agreement modified every year.
Or do you just do, in this agreement, can you just do an appraisal every year?
It would
maybe
you make it his expense if he wants to turn it into the
contract. It's just going to be the...
Can we not just rescind this since it's so complicated?
It's a rescinded. We are starting on a
so
fresh page.
So we don't
page.
Have to do this anymore.
Well, no, but I'm not trying to get in the way of the deal. I understand your point. I'm just trying to say we can do the deal. That was the one element I didn't have was the present value.
Do you have any idea what a third party costs or charges to do an assessment of a company your size?
No, I don't. I mean, but I could contact and see.
I was going to say, to have that clause in there, obviously the county will probably want to pick that third party, so we feel it's a fair third party. The question is, would you be willing to pay that in the agreement? Since Ms. Mills has a concern with, obviously, who's going to pay that every year.
I have a concern with any open-ended.
Look, I'm trying to find a solution.
The value for the entire fleet, and it's more than ambulances, it's ambulances and it's equipment and it's things, is $550,000. That's the value they provided to it. I don't think anything is jumping out at me that says that's not the correct value, but I think, you know, before finance signs off of it, I understand that. I mean, you're saying, look, I'm not an ambulance expert. I don't know what that value is. That looks as good as any other number. It doesn't seem high by any stretch, but I just thought I have an abundance of caution ought to bring to you this concern. If you all want to go forward with this, I have a depreciation schedule that is ready to be part of an exhibit to this agreement right now.
Mr. Gruen, have you ever dealt with these before? Is there a set percentage of companies charged based on the amount that they find the company's value is, that they get a percentage of that as their fee?
To do an appraisal?
Well, it's not appraisal of the company. It's only the vehicles and equipment.
To appraise the equipment.
That's correct.
It's not the company.
It's not the company.
No, I very defer to Don. I'm used to seeing more often a fixed fee. I don't know that they take a percentage of what they appraise.
That would tend to
influence the appraisal.
And Mr. Rutledge, are you willing to take on that?
As long as it's a reasonable cost, I'm willing to take it.
We don't know what that is, though. This is,
I mean, I don't think it's going to be that much, Commissioner.
So up $2?
Well, we got to $550. It couldn't That's what he submitted right now.
He submitted $550,000, and Mr. Gruen's running an appreciation schedule that gets us home.
So that's the up to number right now. I mean, he's agreed.
We will have to hire somebody, to do our own appraisal to see.
Are there any way that there's any book value we can look at, or being parameters to buy this resales, or
I don't know. Would anybody at, would anybody at Fleet be able to do this with any sort of something?
See, the other problem is that it sounds like it's probably going to change every year. It's not like is the equipment that you depreciate it. It's this equipment, and then it'll change.
Well, then that means we have to rewrite the contract.
No, see, I can answer that. We're entering into a 5-year agreement right now, and this is the baseline. And to the extent that ambulances change, unless you modify the agreement, this is all we would be responsible for buying back.
Just what was here. Time.
That's what I'm saying. But if you want us to add a new ambulance next year, we'd have to change the.
We would have to change the agreement to fold that ambulance into.
That's what I'm saying.
Is that?
I mean, it's just more paperwork for us. We can't
reassess and re-evaluate every year, you're going to do now. Pull all that back in.
I hate it.
Can I make a suggestion? If we do it at this amount and not be able to see this amount, it would only leave Mr. Rutledge short if he does add new ones in, and leave it up to him as the option if he wants to sell it to the county for that low number.
But that may be a high number. We're looking at a basis that, in reality, it may be only worth $450. I'm not saying Stan's wrong, but that, how cars and things depreciate. So we're looking at $550, and his value is an up figure. But it could be, in reality, $400, $450 if we take an appraisal of everything. If we buy him out, we're going to pay him $550.
How much is a new ambulance? Loaded out, already ready to go, hit the street.
With equipment on?
Yeah, equipment on, ready to go.
About 175.
And how many of them do you have?
But now
and
that's
then
all
how many
new
years did you depreciate that over?
Five. The truck itself is 5 years.
And of course, I don't have to tell you that you line up 6 appraisers and ask them to give you your opinion. You get 6 opinions.
I sure wish we'd have known this was going to be a. Besides today, so we could add a few days left.
It's fair. It's fair enough.
Work out their own numbers.
I didn't realize it was an issue today till today, but it's a fair. The board would be fully within its rights to go ahead. If you all want to approve this new construct, let me work with Mr. Gruen and Mr. Rutledge, because it wouldn't be ready until a consent agenda in 2 weeks anyway. I could go ahead and do that. I wanted to let you know what the issues I'm grappling with are.
At that time, we'll get Fleet involved and let them see if they can help and name Gruen.
I don't know that I'm going to be able to bring you back a number with as much certainty as my staff and we can all work with, okay?
But if we don't have a degree of, confidence in it, or if we still have doubt, not in a confidence in your work, but in the agreement, we can just vote not to add it in?
Well,
since it's not a part of the contract, or are we voting that it'll be a part of the contract now, what we've done.
If we get to the point where it's time to ratify for good this agreement, and I don't feel like in conjunction with my finance director or my fire director of fire department, that we don't have a number that we're comfortable with, I'll take it off. I'll ask you to take it off consent. We'll talk about it on new business.
So do we need a vote on this, or just you go and work on it and bring it back?
I would rather, why don't we go ahead and vote on this with it heading to consent, but I'll take it off consent if I don't have a comfort level that I've got you a document we can live with.
I mean, right now, I don't know that I can be comfortable with doing it at all.
Can I make a recommendation? Forget about consent. If you want to vote on it today, and we'll ask the clerk to put it on the old business agenda. That way it will be discussed again.
Would you like to make a motion, Ms. Bills?
I'll make a motion that we will, for consideration of the amendment to the ambulance contract, advance the ambulance as
presented
by our county attorney.
And this would be put on February 7th.
New old business agenda.
Old business
agenda. Let's make Ms. Mills, if you're agreeable, can we make that part of the motion? It will go on the old business agenda.
Yes, and make it. It will go on the old business February 7th.
Thank you.
I'll second that motion.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries 5-0. Item 3, adopting the resolution amending the fiscal year 2013 budget for the adjustment of ambulance services. Director of Finance?
Yes, this is the additional funding we need to make available for this account. Still carries through the entire 2013 year, and which adds $47,834 to that account line for this contract. It was just approved on by the board for the next meeting. This comes out of the general fund.
This is not time sensitive.
No, at this point not. Covering the entire year, we had funding in that line all for this amount. So it's not time sensitive.
One thing I'd like to consider is, Dave and the board, is this a one-time payment or is this through a 12-month period?
This
is only for this year's budget, right? The budget process for 2014.
Check we write in January, or will they receive those funds through a 12-month period?
12-month period.
Okay. Oh, it is. I got those. Gotcha.
Is that?
I thought it was one-time.
He said he didn't hear it.
Spread over 12-month period.
That's supposed to be one time.
Yeah, he said agreeable.
All right, okay, we're good.
Do we have a motion then?
One time this year.
I'll make a motion to amend the fiscal year 2013 budget as stated by the finance director. And it'll be $47,000 to be dispersed during a 12-month period.
$47,834.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No, I said aye, but I did have a question I wanted to ask Donna, if I may. What does that reflect in the contract, that what savings to the county, the dollar amount?
Over the original proposed 3% and 7% cumulative,
yes.
It'd be about $307,706.
Gotcha.
Yeah, okay.
Thank
you. Last renewal.